Sophie Wessex and Edward spoke of tragic pregnancy loss paving way for Meghan and Harry. Meghan Markle has spoken out about the devastating experience of losing her second child to a miscarriage in July. The Duchess is not the first royal to share their pregnancy loss experience, as Sophie Wessex and Prince Edward previously opened up about their traumatic pregnancy loss too. Meghan Markle, 39, has been praised for writing a candid piece detailing the heartbreaking experience of losing her and Prince Harry's second baby after she had a miscarriage in July. The Duchess's article for The New York Times touched on the almost unbearable grief she felt at having lost her child. The Duchess hoped that by sharing her story she might be able to remove some of the stigma which exists around pregnancy loss to this day. While one in four pregnancies in the UK end in miscarriage, it is a topic that many still consider taboo. Meghan's brave article makes her the third royal to open up about difficult pregnancy experiences in recent years. The Queen's granddaughters Zara, Tyndall and her husband Mike revealed they suffered two miscarriages before their second daughter Lena's birth in 2018. In 2001, Sophie, Countess of Wessex, and Prince Edward had a traumatic experience during Sophie's first pregnancy which could have been fatal. The Countess was 37 at the time and had a life-threatening ectopic pregnancy and had to be rushed to hospital to receive emergency surgery. While Sophie was recovering in hospital, Prince Edward opened up about the deeply traumatic experience. Speaking to reporters gathered outside the hospital, Edward said, "It's obviously a very traumatic time and my wife has, it's quite the most painful thing that anyone can undergo." Edward said, "It's a pretty traumatic experience. As the pain reduces, so the relief will increase." He added, "The patient is still in a limited amount of discomfort and will be, I imagine, for some days. I want to add my thanks to all the medical team who have done a fantastic job and reacted so quickly and have handled things so professionally." Sophie was flown to King Edward VII's private hospital in London by Royal Berkshire Air Ambulance from home in Surrey.